I don't think you can understand what is happening in India today until you have understand what happened in Gujarat over 12 years. What was the Gujarat model? It set out to create second-class citizenship of minorities. A lot of people say, let's get on with it, let's move on. The first thing that I have to say is that we have the right to move on only when the victims are able to move on.
When people say, how do you look back at Gujarat? And I find that phrase all wrong. I do not look back at Gujarat because Gujarat is very much here with me in the present. And the continuity of that cannot be denied.
Half the people who were displaced by the violence could never return because there were conditionalities. You will not pursue your legal case. You will live in separately, etc., etc.
Gujarat remains relevant unless this hate stops, and good luck with that to all of us. Gujarat remains my reference point for a moral law.
79,000 people from 13 districts have not returned to their homes. This riot did not return to normalcy. And the claim that there was a return to normalcy is false. It has to be challenged.
There are four things that are required for healing and for one to move on. The first is acknowledgement, at least to say that this happened. The second is remorse, that we feel badly that this has happened, a public statement of remorse. And Mr. Modi instead led what he called the Gaurav Yatra 3 months after the massacre. So what did that mean? And the kind of speeches that we are hearing now actually are ironically and eerily very similar to the speeches that were made during the Gaurav Yatra, which demonized the Muslim, equated the Muslim with Pakistan. When he was asked, why are you not even setting up relief camps, he replied, I think, one of the worst hate statements that I've heard from any head of government, and that was, I'm not setting up relief camps because I don't want to set up baby-producing factories. The third is reparation, helping people rebuild their lives. But we saw organized boycott. And the fourth is justice, and my book extensively describes how justice was systematically subverted.
It is not just a set of sporadic attacks. The riot did end with the riot. It continued as the consumption of violence. The way this violence was replayed again and again, I think, was a very important part of the continuity of the riot.
I do think it is important for us to gather in places of solidarity and speak, because there is a sense of despair and fear, and we also have to help each other make sense of these times.